Ladies and gentlemen.
All right, looks like we're about ready to start.
Yes, we are. The first match will be between the Spartans and the Fallen Angels, I do believe.
Yes, that is the Fallen Angels. And we bring you all the action. Tyler is reminding our players that they cannot throw beyond that yellow line he just stood on.
Yeah.
And the game has started.
Yes, it has.
Scrambles for a ball. Oh. We have our first throw of the night coming. It's high.
Oh, come on. Oh, little headshot.
A lot of dodging by, looks like Elijah. No, that is Dominic, and he is out.
Ooh.
Oh, he is not the first one I expected to go out in this round.
Yeah, just sometimes it happens, you know? You hate to see it happen,
Tyler,
but it happens.
Ooh, Tyler's just throwing way too high. A throw from Tyler Rash. Plays goalie for the high school soccer team, I believe.
Yes, he does.
Oh, there's a catch. Someone is out on the Angels.
That was a very nice catch. Get him some gloves.
Oh, ooh, Dominic. Smooth dodging. Going over on the far side.
That's not Dominic.
A funny story about the Fallen Angels. When we first received their sign-up sheet with their roster, they listed themselves as the Fallen Angels.
Yeah.
Apparently they think Angel can spell itself sideways and still be valid. So if they win and they're...
Oh nice catch.
Someone is out. We don't see anyone coming off the court for that, though.
Yeah, again, Brett, that just comes back to the cheating that we talked about before, the dirty play.
Yeah.
It's like the Nature Boys out there or something.
Yes. Oh, we have a fault. Oh, he is out of there.
He is gone.
Tyler Rash just tried to throw from beyond the throwing line and was immediately removed from the field of play.
Get back in your goalie box, huh?
Well, the refs certainly didn't miss that one.
No, they didn't. Their eyes are wide open.
Yeah, I'm reminded of the Mexico. Oh, there is another
nice catch.
Oh, this kid has got hands of glue.
Or maybe his hands are just full of glue. That could be.
It could be. He oozes it out of his pores, just like Spider-Man.
Yeah.
So we'll call him Tobey Maguire.
That sounds good to me.
Looks like with his catch, he brought Tyler Rash back in.
He's gone.
A little bit greedy on that.
Yeah, sometimes, it just happens.
Turnover just wouldn't come for him.
Like in the Super Bowl of, 89. What a catch that was.
I have no clue what catch you're talking about.
Oh, you know which one.
Sorry, not a football fan.
That happens.
Oh, that throw from Laura goes wide. It looks like she was trying to hit one of the spectators.
Yeah, that's just another dirty shot that they're trying to throw out there. Oh, nice deflection. It's the way to use the ball.
Oh, looks like Laura might have caught a throw. No, maybe it's off the bounce. Laura's trying to decide where to throw. There are only two members of her team left on the court, herself and Dominic Colby. Colby's an interesting story. He comes from the developmental league. Oh, Laura is out.
Oh, she's
leaves
just
it
gone.
Dominic comes from the developmental league in Australia. He's not much of a thrower, but that little boy can dodge, I tell you.
Yep, and he can dip.
When they talk about the rules of dodgeball, the dodge, dip, duck, dive, and dodge, that boy has got the 5 Ds down.
Down.
All the way downtown. We can watch. He's just made it two in a row. He's waiting to throw another. Oh, Tyler picks one up, comes back into the safe zone to throw, as does Kyle. Both throws go wide. Oh,
nice
Dominic
catch. He's
caught.
He's gone.
Kyle is out. Kyle comes back in.
Kyle just couldn't handle it.
Oh, nope. Looks like Dominic Cole. Dominic.
That's what we like to see.
Oh, Dominic releases with a lot of fury. Looks like he wasn't too happy about being one of the first ones out.
No, I don't think so. I think he wants to redeem himself right here.
There he goes. What's up? Misses. And is lucky that ball did not hit him.
Very lucky. Very lucky indeed.
Throws. Very nice evasion tactics by the Spartans.
This guy's just throwing bullets right now.
He is. Oh, he gets a double hit. A double hit. Avery is definitely out. Check should be out by that.
you know, the referees just got to open their eyes again. I mean, it just happens.
Yeah. Well, we do have a rookie with us tonight, but I think that one rests on the heads, or the shoulders of our Mexico League vet.
Yeah, you know, the rules are a little bit different there, though, than here. You know, they do like to play a little bit dirtier. It happens.
They do. They play pretty hard and fast. Loose with the rules, really.
Yeah, yeah, that I would agree with. Oh, they got another one out.
Oh, Tyler Rash out again.
The Spartans are starting to fall.
The Spartans left three. It's a 3-on-2. Dominic and Dominic versus the three remaining. Now, how much time do we have in these matches, Ty? Dominic is out again on a catch.
The left back is just Dominic on Dominic.
The return throw is too high. That's been their problem the whole game to get this Dominic out. And am I mistaken, or he just kicked the balls to them?
That could be, you know. You got to play on that defensive. Sometimes the offense just can't do it.
Now, if they were smart, they would throw all of these balls at once.
He's gone.
It looks like the Spartans have put away the Fallen Angels in round one, game one of the H2O Friday Night Flood Dodgeball Tournament. And it looks like Kyle goes onto the ground.
That looks like Ted Ginn Jr. all over again.
Can't catch, can't run, can't stay on his feet.
Yeah, but somehow he's still in the pros. What happened there?
They don't have anyone better on the roster. There's a shot of the Fallen Angels. Doesn't seem like there's much sportsmanship in tonight's tournament.
No, not really, you know.
I didn't see much high-fiving or handshaking or even just a congratulations, good game.
Yeah, that really doesn't happen all that much in dodgeball. It's a doggy-dog world.
It is, and in this world, the St. Bernard looks like he won.